Hi, my name is Amrish. You're watching Gourmet at Home. Today, I will be preparing a recipe of paneer butter masala, one of the most comfort dish that we order when we go to a restaurant. After watching today's recipe, you will be making paneer butter masala in your kitchen. It's all about good quality ingredients, spices, no fancy equipments, following the right process. Let's start making the recipe of paneer butter masala. For the recipe of paneer butter masala, I have got some basic spices that we have in our kitchen like turmeric powder, coriander powder, chili powder, green cardamom, bay leaf, cumin and some coriander seeds. Along with that, I have got some grated tomatoes, chopped onion, ginger, garlic, cashew paste, butter, coriander and paneer. So let's start. I will start by adding some oil to the kadhai, approximately 3 tablespoons of vegetable oil. The oil is getting ready. I will crush some green cardamom and coriander seeds. So my coriander seeds are ready, green cardamom is ready. So I will measure my cumin seed. I have taken approximately 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds and 3 bay leaves. After adding the spices, I will add 2 medium-sized chopped onions. After adding the onions, I will add 1/2 a teaspoon of salt. In most of the recipes, I have seen people start making paneer butter masala by adding butter to the pan followed by spices. But in this recipe of paneer butter masala, we will be adding butter towards the end because butter is high on viscosity, so it carries the flavor. So if you're adding the butter towards the end, you will have the freshness of the spices that you have added along with the fresh flavor of butter in it. At this stage, the onions are soft, so we will add chopped garlic along with 1/2 a teaspoon of chopped green chili. The onions are almost golden brown. We will add 2 teaspoons of coriander powder. After the coriander powder, I will add grated tomatoes. We will continue cooking the onions and tomatoes until they are thick in texture. We have used chopped onions and grated tomatoes. Remember, it's paneer butter masala. So we wanted to create a masala where the texture is comparable with butter. In most of the recipes, people use tomato puree for that or onion puree for that. So that's a different recipe, which is paneer makhni. So paneer makhni and paneer butter masala, they are two different curries. In makhni, the texture is more smoother and it's a pureed gravy. But paneer butter masala is not a pureed gravy, but you have a thick masala which has a texture which is comparable with butter. And in this recipe of paneer butter masala, I have used 1:3 ratio of onion and tomato, where if you have got 1 kg of onion, you will be using 3 kg of red tomatoes. So make sure your tomatoes should be ripe, they should be soft, they should not be firm. Otherwise, you will not have that sweetness of tomatoes coming in your gravy. So now we are almost 50% done with our masala. So masala is getting thicker. At this stage, we will add 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder and 2 teaspoons of chili powder. So I'm using Kashmiri chili for this, so it's not very spicy. Now we can see the masala is almost getting ready. So there are very few specks of oil we can see on the side of the kadhai. Because I have used less oil in this recipe, I will be finishing my paneer butter masala with some butter. So I just want to balance the butter and oil in this recipe. Now the masala is thick in texture. We will add 2 tablespoons of cashew paste. This cashew paste I have prepared with fried cashews, or you can roast the cashews also. You can roast the cashews in the pan, soak them in water for 15 to 20 minutes, and then you can blend them to a fine puree. So once you will add the cashew nut paste, you need to be a little careful because now this paste will stick on the bottom of the pan. So you need to continuously mix the masala. And if required, you can add little water in between. So after adding the cashew nut paste, I will be adding 50% of cream and 50% of milk. And if you have noticed, in the beginning, I have used less oil because I want to finish my paneer butter masala with some butter in it. So your masala or your gravy towards the end will not be very heavy. It's a very home style recipe of paneer butter masala that you can enjoy for your lunch and for your dinner. And now we will mix them together and we'll continue cooking for another 15 to 20 minutes. Now after mixing the cream and milk, we will add some salt and sugar. Now this salt and sugar is a part of the seasoning. So you need to understand your tomatoes. If your tomatoes are sour, then the quantity of sugar will be more. But if your tomatoes are not sour, which means if you're making this masala in winter time, when the tomatoes are not very sour, they're sweet in taste. That time you need to add less sugar in the masala. After adding the sugar and salt, here comes the hero ingredient, which is the paneer. After the paneer, I will add half a teaspoon of garam masala, half a teaspoon of green cardamom powder, chopped ginger, some crushed fenugreek leaves, and this will make it very classical Punjabi style paneer butter masala. After adding the kasuri methi, I will add lots of chopped coriander and 3 to 4 knobs of butter. Now, another important thing to share, I have added the butter towards the end. I have finished the masala with some flavors like green cardamom, kasuri methi, garam masala. Then I have added the butter because now this butter will carry all these flavors in the masala. The paneer butter masala is almost ready. You can serve this paneer butter masala with lachcha paratha or naan bread. You are watching Gourmet at Home. We'll be serving our paneer butter masala with this bun. Now in this step, I have taken a bun, scooped it from the center, and I have filled it with paneer butter masala, finished with some grated paneer and mozzarella cheese, some fresh coriander, and then I have baked this in the oven for 3 to 4 minutes at 200 degrees centigrade. Paneer butter masala bun is ready. So let's taste. But before that, I need to plate that for you.
Roasted papadum. I've got some seasonal lettuce greens and a pickled cucumber.
Hope you enjoyed watching this recipe of home style paneer butter masala. Try this in your kitchen. I will see you in my next video. Until then, bye.